I cannot believe that this is about to be the last video before our baby girl's being born video. From here on out, my doctors are going to be doing something called a non-stress test. That's where they keep an eye on baby girl's heart rate, my heart rate, and they just kind of make sure I'm not having any contractions and stuff as well. I'm going to be doing that twice a week, every Monday and Thursday, all the way up until baby girl is born. I am 32 weeks and 3 days pregnant as of today. I will be doing my first stress test today, and I will be seeing my high-risk doctor to do our normal checkups that we do every couple weeks. Instead of going every 2 weeks, we actually go about every 3 weeks now to do the typical measuring, checking the cerclage, seeing how much she weighs. But today, I'm so excited because we're supposed to find out the date that her scheduled C-section is supposed to be. So I'm so excited! I will be checking in with you guys as soon as I get done with the testing and seeing my high-risk doctor to let you know what's going on. Baby girl and I passed our first round of non-stress testing, and we did the measuring and the weighing. She is weighing 4 pounds, 12 ounces, and she's still measuring a week ahead of schedule. We did also find out that her scheduled C-section date is supposed to be September 20th, which would be 39 weeks. Originally, he was going to take her out at 37 weeks, but he said because everything looks so good in there that we're going to go ahead and aim for 39 weeks. But he did say that I need to understand that she could come naturally anytime between 37 and 39 weeks. So now it's officially time to tie up our little loose odds and ends and do things like finish up her room and get the car seat in the car and pack hospital bags and I guess pretty much just play the waiting game, which is kind of cool because that's pretty much what normal pregnant women do. So I kind of get to do what normal pregnant women do in a sense, which is cool to me because I didn't get a chance to do that last time.
I got kicked around. I've been black and blue on my own way to you. All the stars I've seen, all the songs I've sung, all the beers I've drank, all the damage done, 'cause I'm on my way to you. I was on my way to you. On my way to you. On my way to you.
I am officially packing baby girl's hospital bag.
Nothing feels better than this. Nothing feels better. Nothing feels better than this. Nothing feels better. I'm not. We don't got high.
So yesterday I was admitted into the hospital. I was having contractions about 8 minutes apart, and they were showing up on the monitors at the hospital as well that they were pretty close together and pretty intense. I was given medication to help stop the contractions because the doctors and nurses would just like her to stay on board a little bit longer, even though everybody is saying that, you know, if she was born at this time, she would be okay, and there's a possibility that she may not need NICU time if she were to come out at this point. But to be on the safe side, we want her to just try and stay in a little bit longer, and they also administered a round of steroid shots yesterday, which helps with lung development and other little things inside of her body that are just at the very end of getting done developing. I will be getting a second round of steroid shots this morning as well. As of the middle of the night last night, the contractions have actually eased up and pretty much gone away completely by some miracle. So I am praying with everything inside of me that maybe they'll just go ahead and release me from the hospital today so I can just go rest in the comfort of my own home. I know that being in the comfort of my own home would honestly be best for my physical and mental well-being, not only for myself, but for baby girl as well. Honestly, playing this waiting game here in the hospital, it hits way too close to home of what I went through and did back in 2015, and I just can't do it again. So I just got the news from my high-risk doctor and the doctors that are doing their rounds here today that I do officially get to go home. They are sending me home on the medication that they've been giving me here in the hospital to keep the contractions at bay. My high-risk doctor did say that we are going to go ahead and talk on Monday at my appointment with him about moving up the C-section date, so I will officially know on Monday what the new C-section date is. It's not guaranteed that she's even going to stay on board until that date, but optimistically thinking and hoping and praying that she will. So it looks like this video is going to be coming to an end, and it looks like we're going to be having a birthday video before we know it. Hopefully not too soon, though.